So we may start. It is a pleasure to have with us today Mrs. Constantina Founta. She has studied economics, and now she's about to finish her PhD in a few days or weeks. She will be presenting her work under the supervision of Professor Lucas Achillas and people in the audience that they know Lucas. Lucas has a background in astronomy, and we are collaborators in the area of nonlinear dynamics, dynamical systems, etc. And a recent branch of research at the economy department of the University of Thessaly is about modeling battles, viewing the battles as dynamical systems. And Mrs. Founta has applied this theory in the famous Battle of Salamis. And at the Academy, the Battle of Salamis has another interest, and we are glad that we have colleagues from the Department of Climatology today to follow the talk, and the General Secretary of the Academy himself has worked on that. So there is a broader interest for the Research Center of Astronomy. Of course, the weight is put on the mathematical modeling of the nonlinear dynamical system that it can be viewed the Battle of Salamis in this way. So we may start, and at the end, or if someone wants to interrupt for briefly to ask a question, is free to do that. I will be here and control the discussion. And at the end, in any case, we will have time for questions. So Constantina, you can start.
Okay, thank you. First of all, thank you for the invitation. Let's start. Our aim to develop a mathematical tool which studies actually the player's strategic behavior during a battle. The presented model provides information to the strategic analysts or practitioners in decision making, and highlights the most crucial factors that affect in the outcome of a battle or its overturn. The research questions that we will answer today are first, which strategic behavior should adopt a player when he is faced with external threats? Secondly, could he withstand the attacks autonomously, meaning that without allies' interventions? And if the allies' participation is necessary, how crucial is the allies' intervention during a battle? Modeling a simulation actually contribute to decision making. Several combat models are developed to describe combat situations or weapon systems. Our model is a combat model. And in general, there are two categories of combat models. The first category is called perspective models, which we search for the optimal course of action in a combat situation. Our model belongs in this category. And the other category is the descriptive models, which describe battle phenomena and processes, such as Monte Carlo simulation. At first, I would like to present you our idea and how we develop the framework and the model. In USA, there is a colonel called Leak, who said that the military strategy is a combination of ends, ways, and means. And he presented this phrase by this image. So we have a stool with three legs. Each leg represents ends, ways, and means. And these three legs have to be in balance to have a successful military strategy. His framework, we think that it's a little bit static, so we try to change it, and we think that it could be more dynamical. So we believe that the element of optimal strategic behavior is missing in his statement. So our contribution is actually this introduction, the optimal strategic behavior, which means the combination of balance and readjustment. We draw this photo to describe our contribution. So we have a table and a few players sit around the table to play a game or to participate in a battle. This table has three legs, ends, ways, and means. These legs have to be in balance in every different environment, competitive environment. So we insert these red things to adjust and balance these three legs to play the game. And these three things represent the optimal strategic behavior of the players. In addition, we used the philosophy of the game called Hot Dog to interpret the solutions of our model. So in this game, we have two players who can behave either as a hawk or a dog. If a player behaves as a hawk, it means that the player has an aggressive behavior. And if a player behaves as a dog, it means that the player has a more defensive behavior. The solution of the game is that... Sorry?
No, go on. Please, if you can mute Jason Bassett, if you can mute your computer so that there are some...
Apologies. Sounds
coming out. Yeah, please. Yeah, thank you.
Okay. The player with the hawkish behavior wins the game. So in the next slide, we will see how we interpret the solutions of the model with using the words aggressive or defensive strategic behaviors according to the philosophy of the game. So here we have the model. It's actually a very simple version of the model. As you can see, it's a discrete dynamical system of equations. Each equation describes the estimated strategic behavior of each player. And let me explain how we develop each equation. So in the first equation, player X at the time T plus one, which means that the estimated strategic behavior of the player tomorrow depends on two parts. The first part is the sum of these two parameters. The parameter PX expresses the military strength of the player, and the parameter TNX expresses in general the technological capability in the battle. But in this study, we focus on the Battle of Salamis, so we have the technological naval capability of player X. These two parameters, this sum, actually is expresses the substance of the player. And the other part expresses the negative influence of his opponent. So we have the parameter G, which is the difficulty of the battlefield. And also in this parameter, we include the weather phenomena during the battle. The parameter DX expresses the damage that the player X brings to player, sorry, the player Y brings to player X. And the parameter EX expresses the estimated preparation costs of player X for the impending battle. This part is, sorry, it's actually the logistic equation. It's a population model, and we use it to express the variation between wins and losses. The other equation expresses the estimated strategic behavior of player Y. So we have the sum of military strength of player Y and the technological naval capability of him, minus one minus G. This part, as we see in the first equation, we have G, and the other we have one minus G. This is because each parameter is defined in the closed interval 0, 1. So we have the idea to create the advantage or disadvantage of the geographical terrain. So for example, if the value of G will be 0.3, we think that this battlefield is easy for player X, and for player Y, it will be very difficult. Here we have the damage that the player X brings to Y, and the estimated preparation cost of player X, sorry, Y. And here we have again the logistic equation for the same reason. So every parameter and these two variables are defined in the closed interval 0, 1, and this helps us to interpret them also through game theory as probabilities. This slide explains the definitions for variables and the parameters. Here, The only thing that I need to say that is the parameter T or TN, if we say the technological naval capability, expresses the means. I refer to the table in the previous slide, which is the one leg. The other leg is the ways, and we suppose to the word ways expresses the parameter G, and the ends, we said that this would be the parameter D. Okay. So let's move on to the application of the model in the Battle of Salamis. Here we have three case studies. The first one is we try to approach the reality. So we set initial values to the parameters, and we see the solution, the solutions of the model, and we try to interpret them, and we see that the solution expresses the reality, the real facts of the battle. The second case study is actually some different alternative scenarios of different geographical, we change actually the location of the battle. So we study openly the Saronic Gulf, and the battle would occur in a smooth of Corinth. The last case study is we study the bilateral damages of two opponents. It's actually an hypothetical, some hypothetical scenarios of what could happen if we change the values in the parameter D. So, according to ancient documents, we try to make some to some analogies in the values. So we have in the parameter px is equal to 0.25, and the parameter py is equal to 0.8. This means that the Persians had a stronger fleet than the Greek fleet. The parameter TNX is equal to 0.5, and the parameter TNY is equal to 0.35. This means that the Greek fleet had a stronger naval technological capabilities, because the Greek triremes had an embolus in the front, and they used this to attack the enemy ships. The parameter G is equal to 0.4, which means that the Salamis Straits was an easy battlefield for Greek fleet, and a difficult battlefield for the Persian fleet, because they had not the ability to use more ships in the battle. Then the damage that means the Persians brings to Greeks, we said that it would be 0.8. And the damage that Greeks bring to Persians, we said that would be 0.2. According to Herodotus, I think that Greeks destroyed 2,000 ships, and Persians destroyed 40 Greek ships, I think. Then we have the preparation costs of each side. So again, with ASEAN documents, the Persians spend a lot of money to support they try to expand their territories than the Greeks. So using these initial values, we solve the system, and we have these two equilibrium points. We reject the equilibrium points that they not belong in the closed interval 0, 1, such as equilibrium point E2. And we accept this equilibrium point. And let me interpret this fixed point. As we see, X star is equal to 0.75. This means that this value is close to 1. So it means that the player X, the Greeks, had an aggressive behavior. And the value of Y star is 0.475, which is close to 0. So it means that the Persians had a more defensive behavior through, I think that I read in a book that Xerxes sat on the mountain Aegaleo to see the battle, and his behavior was like they underestimate the Greeks, and he thought that this battle could be an easy one. Through the philosophy of the game Hawk Dove, we see that the player with the aggressive behavior wins the battle. So as you can see, the player X, because of the value is close to 1, it means that the player X, the Greek fleet, wins the battle. If there's any questions, you can tell me. So in the next slide, we see a time series diagram, which represents the duration of the battle and the outcome of the battle. So we see the blue line is above the red. The blue line expresses the Greeks, and the blue line expresses the Persians. So if the blue line is above the red, it means that the player X wins the battle. So it's very clear that the Greeks, through the time, will win the battle. The other figure is a bifurcation diagram for different values of parameter G. As the parameter G, as the value of parameter G increases, we see that the blue line is above the red. So as the difficulty of the battle changes, meaning that becomes more difficult for Greeks, the Greek fleet continue to win until the value 0.64, which is a critical point. And then we have the overturn of the outcome of the battle. And this is an alternative scenario that we will study in the next slides. So here we have another alternative scenario of the battle, meaning that we change the location of the battle. We suppose that the battle would occur in openly the surrounding Gulf. So to express this location, we change the value of parameter G to 0.64, and we keep all the other parameters constant. We solve again the system, and we got these two equilibrium points. As you can see, it's actually a critical point because these two values are very close to each other. So it's a critical point that we have the overturn of the outcome of the battle. And in this time series, we see that the red line starts to be above the blue. So the Persians give a lot of ships, and we try to take the advantage of this location to win the battle. Here we have another possible location that the battle would occur. We change the value of parameter to express the smooth of Corinth to 0.7. So we see that this value is close to one, and it means that this location would be very difficult for the Greek fleet. We keep all the other values of parameter constant, and we solve again the system, and we get these two equilibrium points. As you can see, the values of these two equilibrium points are close to one, so both have an aggressive behavior. But as you can see in the time series diagram, the red line is above the blue, which means that the Persian fleet will win. We are pretty sure about that. Through all these three battlefields, we see that the Salamis Straits are the best location for the Greek fleet to win the battle. And the Persian fleet had the disadvantage to set a lot of ships during the battle. This slide shows different scenarios of bilateral damages of the two opponents. In the first case, we suppose that each one caused to each other the same damage. And we observe that the blue line is above the red. So we could say that the Greek fleet would win the battle. These three scenarios, in these three scenarios, we refer to the battle would take place in the Salamis Straits. In the other scenario, we suppose that the Greeks cause 30% damage to the Persian fleet, while the Persians cause 70% damage to the Greek fleet. So in this case, we see that the red line is above the blue. So we suppose that the Persians will win this battle in this case. And the last scenario is the real damage that caused to each other. So we have the Greeks cause 80% damage to the Greek to the Persian fleet, and the Persians cause 80% damage to the Greeks. And also in this case, the blue line is above the red, and it means that the Greek fleet win this battle if the percentages of the damages are this. In conclusion, we try to connect the game theory and the dynamical systems using the framework and the idea of the game Hawk Dove. We developed also a model, a combat model, to predict how the players will behave during a battle. We apply this model in the Battle of Salamis, and the results we took was a proof of the historical events. Also, we studied several hypothetical scenarios by changing the geographical location of the battle. And we conclude that the Salamis Straits was the ideal location for the Greek fleet to win this armament conflict. And the last alternative scenario was the study of several bilateral damages of these two players. And we saw that the Greek fleet would cause up to 50% damages in the Persian fleet to win the battle in Salamis Straits. Thank you so much. And I'm here to hear your questions for you, of you.
Yeah. Thank you very much for the presentation. Very, very interesting. So actually, if I understood it correctly, the model is a variation of the logistic map, right? The logistic equation with some parameters that describe the evolution of the battle. Is that correct?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Okay. And actually, this is would be more useful to be analyzed before the battle, so that we reach the same conclusion like Themistocles, that the Straits of Salamis were preferable with respect to conducting the battle at Corinth or something like that. So, well, of course, the whole weight in the modeling then is put on the parameters that are described. Can you have you thought of adding more parameters that could describe the details of the battle? Because actually, this is okay where we fight, but also what should we take care during the battlefield, during the battle in the battlefield. In that case, in the well, in the. In the Salam Straits, when we start and the battle is going on, could one add some more parameters to correct possible wrong evolutions? That's what.
The answer is yes. We expand even more the model. To represent a battle of these days. So, as I said before, this is a very simple version of the model. And as if is a simple version, they approach the real facts correctly. And all these parameters that are included in the model, we think that are the most crucial factors that affect in the outcome of the battle.
Yeah.
So of course, we add a few more in the other versions of the model because we have studied another battles of the, I think the other one was the Battle of Midway, and the other and the last battle in my thesis was a theoretical battle that expresses a battle of nowadays.
Yeah.
And there we have a lot of new parameters, and the model changes a lot.
Well, I would like to ask something more, but let me check first if there are people that here in the audience or in.
Okay.
Is there anyone who wants to ask something from here?
Yeah.
Yes, please go.
Very nice talk. I would kindly ask you in the first two, in the second picture presentation. Of the presentation.
In the second slide.
You, you presented the two main categories of the models.
Okay. Yeah.
And we go there.
I think here, yeah.
Yes, I would like to ask you to say something more about those two categories. You say that we have the prescriptive or normative models, mm-hmm. which search for the optimal course of an action in a combat situation, okay? And the descriptive or evaluative models, I think, can you talk about the second class? You talked about Monte Carlo simulation, something like that.
I focus on perspective because...
On the first category.
Yes, because our model belongs in this category.
Okay.
So I don't.
Do you know if any model of the second category has been applied on such a battleship, on a battlefield?
Another.
Do you have any comparison between your model and any other model?
No. I don't know any other.
Okay, that was just a question. Okay, thank you.
Okay, let's check here. I don't see if... Okay, here, we'll go down here. Yeah. Okay, so if there is nobody else from those that are linked to who wants to ask something, let me continue with a question. Now, we have some battles that we know how they evolved. So, for instance, now here the application was on the battleship of Salamis. So can we, okay, that is, I think, a very nice numerical experiment so that we understand if we have put right weights to each factor that affected the battle. So, and then I guess this will be used as a template for modeling battles that have to be fought in the future, which actually this analysis would be the most interesting one. So in the present case, which was the decisive parameter that decided about the outcome of the battle?
In the battle?
In the model, you had the model and then you had the several factors that affected, which was the most decisive one after all.
I think the parameter G, the geographical location of the battle, because as we saw in the alternative scenarios, if we change the location of the battle, the outcome overturns.
Okay. And actually at the there was this bifurcation diagram. Can we go there?
Yes.
Bifurcation diagram that you had it with a G parameter and
yes.
This one. Yes, exactly. So then at the early stages there is a chaotic evolution, right?
Yeah, and we cannot predict what could happen.
And then we know that for until we find the other critical point, then there are just two lines. Then after a certain point, it is obvious that the Greeks win. Is that correct? Then it is not anymore chaotic. The system is very predictable. So,
not exactly. As the parameter G is defined in the closed interval 0, 1, mm-hmm. we focus on this interval in the bifurcation diagram. So we look from 0 to 0.8.
Okay. And so in all these cases, the fact that we have a larger value in the blue curve means that the Greeks win.
I don't know, maybe.
No, the question is, what does the right diagram tell us?
We do not focus on this part. We could say that we cannot predict what could happen, and we just focus on the positive part of the diagram.
Okay.
What is the negative part of
that? The negative part corresponds to what?
Maybe I think it would be the weather phenomena, which brings the not would be it because it would be an unpredictable factor, mm-hmm. and because of the chaos.
Okay. Okay. Then, are there any other questions? If not. When I'm checking here, there is not. If I'm missing something, please speak up. Okay, then we thank person again.
Thank you very much. Can I stop the sharing?
Yeah, if there are no other questions, you may stop. Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for this nice talk. Very interesting.
Thank you.
Thanks for attending.
Maybe for all.